right, hi again, everyone. Gene Okerlund back in the Sports Control Center with my good friend, Roddy Piper, in the absence of the Macho Man. Mr. Piper, kind enough to join us here on All-American Wrestling.
It's my pleasure to be with you.
Roddy, I don't know if you've heard the news, but I'm here to tell you. This past week, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, totally wrecked, trashed, if you will, the offices of the president of the World Wrestling Federation, Jack Tunney. The reason he did that, he went to Tunney. He demanded reinstatement. Tunney says, no way, pal. And, of course, the Macho Man has the wherewithal to do some serious damage.
The Macho Man now holds the World Wrestling Federation Interior Decorating Championship. And half the problem was trying to wake up Tunney. I don't blame him for getting hot, but that's okay. You know why? There'll be some justice around.
I'm sure there will. Jake the Snake Roberts and The Undertaker are watching this situation very closely. I'm certainly, as far as they're concerned, don't want to see any reinstatement for the Macho Man. Now then,
yes.
Mr. Piper, this week, the Bully is going to be here. This guy is really a bully. The British Bulldog is also going to be on hand.
I like him. He's cool.
Big Boss Man.
Whoa, baby, I ain't saying nothing.
He's going to be going against Colonel Mustafa with the...
Him and his one-hump wife, Camel.
The Undertaker also on hand. And this week at the funeral parlor, Paul Bear is going to be chatting with...
Lumpy.
No, he's going to be Ric Flair.
Get out.
The truth, I'm telling you the truth.
What is your major malfunction, Flair? Huh? You calling yourself the real world champion? Like, I've been here for 8 years, and I ain't never done nothing. I scare, Flair. You bring that doggone big gold belt you got. We know it's gold, because every time Boobs touches us, his hands turn green, yes?
You do me a favor. Get Dr. Jabroni in here. I want to get this guy's blood pressure. Let's get up to the ring for our opening bout. Here we go.
My favorite.
All right, there's that bully. I can't stand a bully.
Thinks he's John L. Sullivan, man.
I think you just saw in the special report that the Macho Man, Randy Savage, now has formally apologized to World Wrestling Federation President Jack Tunney. The Macho Man went through his office... I don't know how to describe that without, he trashed it.
We're talking Dixie Dumpster there, folks. And you know what else? They made him apologize. I don't believe for one second that Macho meant it. I wouldn't mean it. If it was your wife and a snake and your snake, would you apologize? I think the Macho's setting him up. I think you get a nice friendly, you know, on the good ship, lollipop. And then when you least expect it.
By the way, I should point out, at that reception immediately following SummerSlam, that unwarranted attack by Jake the Snake Roberts and The Undertaker, that snake, that cobra, was stuck right in the face of Miss Elizabeth. Now, the trauma that she has suffered undoubtedly is going to take time for something. You just don't get over something like that overnight.
I'm telling you, I'm scared to death of snakes. I don't know if Elizabeth will ever get over something like that. I hear she wakes up in the morning and screams. I hear she wakes up in the middle of the night and screams. I don't know that you can ever get over something like that.
The road, we have to pay a visit to the, to the funeral parlor.
Lumpy, huh?
Everybody, unless you want to. You want to go the sizzle route? Let's join Paul Bear right now.
Hear us, maybe next.
The foam hand, Roddy Piper, please. No, come on now. That's the likeness of The Undertaker. And if we reverse this, on the other side, rest in peace. This is a tombstone.
It's about the ego of this guy. Of course, he's a scary-looking guy. Hard to get a date because he hangs around with Lumpy. Now he's doing all kinds of stuff, getting in with snakes. Speaking of snakes, have you seen Flair lately?
No, but the speculation is over. He has arrived at the World Wrestling Federation. Of course, I'm talking about Ric Flair. And there are so many things that could be developing right under our very nose.
Well, first of all, Flair's the kind of guy that'll talk through his nose, because it covers his mouth. You ever seen the schnoz on this guy? Flair's the kind of guy gonna come out in wild robes with things hanging off of, trying to impress you. Me? I'm gonna come out in a dress. You think I'm trying to impress anybody? Kilt.
Kilt. Very good. Thank you. Roddy Piper, by the way, I want to thank you filling in here for the Macho Man.
What
do you mean? He's gonna be back next week.
Oh, come on, man.
No, I'm not kidding. He's going to be back.
Elizabeth
is on the recovery trail.
Well, that's good.
And, of course, I want the Macho Man back here for one thing.
I
want him
to
explain what's been going on the past month. We know about him trashing the office of World Wrestling Federation President Jack Tunney, demanding reinstatement. So many things happening. I'm sure it's going to be a very interesting show. But, Roddy, you're always welcome here in the Sports Control Center.
Thank you, and I will be anxious to see what the Macho Man has to say and what he might do. I caught his interior.
For Roddy Piper, Mean Gene Okerlund saying have a good week. Take care. So long.